Ernst. Son of a biscuit, man. I ain't get a chance to do dick. Stay in there, Ernst. Stay in that menu, Ernst. I got 20 seconds. Stay in there. I was trying to stop the broadcast and start it over again so they wouldn't run into each other. And I get a chance to do no changes, Ernst. Which means they get ready to start Jeremy Lin. But they start him on here because he's got the
It's Detroit
rating.
Pistons NBA action. We're in the Motor City where the Pistons are looking to take on a Western Conference opponent. Buckle yourselves in, everybody. It's the NBA on 2K Sports.
Jump.
And
don't
here with Clark Kellogg
right?
And Steve Kerr and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan.
I'm supposed to be getting a Ziploc bag and put it on me so I can just pee on that and stay here, keep playing. Ready, Ernst? All right.
So Detroit will get the first possession.
I saw that.
And now the Lakers starting group.
I got it.
Lee and Kobe are your one and your two. Inside, it's Boozer and Hill. And it's Johnson at the three spot. Now Monroe gets to Jennings. From outside, off the mark.
Wes Johnson, the former number four pick back in 2010. He was a bust in Minnesota, but he shot better in his fourth season. And once he was moved to kind of a small four, like a shooting power forward spot, he really found a niche for himself.
And it's Drummond missing.
That's really too easy a chance to miss, guys. He needs to be more aggressive and focused on his finishes.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside.
And you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
I don't know when to let this dude go.
That free throw, no good.
Dude, it's terrible.
And Wesley Johnson has always been impressive physically. Great size, terrific length for a wing, quick off the floor.
Yeah, he's got all of those ingredients, but his ball handling has been a bit mediocre, rather pedestrian, and I think that's held him back.
And it's Smith finishing it off.
Beautiful work in the transition game.
That's how to do it. Attack early before the defense can get itself set.
Oh, that's different. The free throw.
Shot's good by Boozer. It's Jennings with the drive. Misses off the left iron.
Kind of a shaky first few minutes, guys. Five field goal attempts, only one made.
Bryant dishes to Lynn. Can't hit. And Detroit the other way now. Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. Caldwell Pope pass to Jennings. And he drew the blocking foul. He'll go to the line for two. Wesley Johnson picks one up.
Brandon Jennings, you remember, decided to play a year in Italy right out of high school rather than to go to college. He was the first guy to do that once the NBA implemented that 1 year out of high school requirement for the draft.
Second free throw, no good. And for Brandon Jennings, he didn't play a whole lot while in Rome, but he stayed busy practicing and developing.
Yeah, and it didn't seem to diminish his stock that much, Kevin. You know, you go back to when he was drafted, he was the 10th pick by the Bucks back in 08.
Got to go to the store. No shot!
And the shot is good. Jennings has got his first bucket in this one.
Bible study.
For Los Angeles, they've gone just 1-4 to get this game started. And Kobe, here we go.
Yeah, I was wondering where you've been all the time.
Rebounded by the Pistons. Drummond's got three rebounds now in this one. Out of bounds, Pistons ball as Detroit keeps possession. Now here's Jennings. Shoots it up. Smith on the wing. Kicks it out to Jennings.
And it seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
Jennings with another miss. Caldwell Pope kicks to Jennings. Drilled from 11 feet out.
Come on, Ernst.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
Here's Lynn. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down.
I want him on tape. I want Nash on the court.
It's stolen by Hill. And now here's Johnson, the fast break chance. Here's Lynn. Great touch on the 16-footer. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Jennings dishes to Smith. The shot's good. Jennings making the play. Smith's got 5. Lakers trail by 3.
One of the problems for the Pistons last year was they seemed to collapse late in games. I mean, just found a lot of opportunities that went awry in due to poor performances in the fourth quarter.
Hey, Ern.
Down to 5 on the shot clock.
Ern.
And it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope with the foul. A different look here for Detroit. Caron Butler's checked in for Andre Drummond. Jody Meeks comes in for Caldwell-Pope. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Brandon Jennings. It's Boozer missing.
He had a defender draped all over. Not really the best shot there.
Well, not the shot you hope for when it's well contested like that.
Man, I don't know what happened right there. He just basically walked out of bounds.
Yurebko's checked in for Smith. The Lakers also changing it up. Randall's checked in for Hill. Davis comes in for Carlos Boozer. And Nick Young is subbed in for Jeremy Lin.
Stop shaking the screen, right?
Kobe Bryant in his 19th season in the league, but remember, he's played in 220 career playoff games. That's almost 3 additional seasons.
Stay out of my game, Zula.
Then you factor in his play with Team USA. I tell you, he's got a lot of mileage on those legs.
Zula.
Nash is checked in for Johnson.
Man.
And Kobe Bryant, top 5 in all-time minutes played.
And, Kevin, you know those minutes add up, but he's found ways to overcome the wear and tear and still remain effective. His great skill level and ability to make tough, contested shots remains valuable.
Near the 3-point line, it's Nash. And again, no good by the Lakers. And the call will be against Julius Randle. That is his first foul of the game. Ryan Kelly, he's checked in for
Kobe. High power. I saw him sit down with a fork and a knife.
Hook down low that time, and he got the 3-second call. The Lakers trail. The dish now to Young. Good.
Swaggy P. Sago.
The Pistons have gone 4-of-10 shooting the ball here in the first quarter. And Augustine kicks to Monroe. He dishes it to Meeks. Can't hit from in close.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
And here's Nash outside. Nash with another miss. Meeks passes to Augustine. Butler from outside. And that one's good. Butler's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Here's Nash.
R. Kelly, yeah, that's him.
Well-placed jumper from the free throw line.
I'll tell you what, fellas, he loves those mid-range jumpers. I mean, that's where he makes his money.
They did you last year. He made sure he had a question.
And now the first timeout called here for Detroit.
Yep. He got a swag heat on. Detroit penises, girls. I mean, pistons. Well, you're right, man. You're right. I should be saying that about it. That's right. That's supposed to be Van Gundy. That look like him. He like got the mumps. I didn't realize that. I thought that's right. Van Gundy did go down. He looked like him, man.
Detroit's gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from three-point range so far in the first. Augustine, no luck. For Los Angeles, they've gone 5 of 12 from the field since the opening tip. Nash kicks to Kelly. Young with no one around. And the three ball is good. Young's got 5 now.
That was some skill there. Nice use of the bounce pass.
Knock that boy down.
And there's the foul against the Lakers.
That's R. Kelly in the public announcement right there, buddy.
So it's Detroit now. They trail by 3. Now here's Nash. He's guarded close. That doesn't go either for Nash.
It has not been an easy quarter for him. At least offensively speaking.
Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Here's Monroe. And Davis pulls it down. Augustine again. It's Nash. The 19-foot shot. Again, Nash missing. Outside, Meeks buried it just in the neck of time.
He sure did, right on cue. Man, was that major drama. He loves those situations.
Tie game in Detroit. We'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from Detroit?
I was impressed with their transition game, guys. They really got out and ran the lanes.
Yeah, they did. I mean, no better way to get easy buckets than through fast breaks.
On the wings, KCP and Josh Smith. Monroe and Drummond, they're inside. And it's Jennings in at the point. They're the group Detroit will start the second with. Davius Caldwell-Pope, KCP, drafted 8th overall last season by the Pistons. Steve drafting for need there.
Yeah, Caldwell-Pope coming out of Georgia. He's got that three-point range. Really promising defender, too, at that two-guard spot.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, thank you, Kevin. Julius Randle, the fresh-faced rookie for the Lakers, wore number 30 in college at Kentucky and wears it now. As a kid, he asked his mother if it was okay if he wore the same number that she used to wear. She said if he wore it, he had to do something with it. Big shoes to fill, but he's up to the task, guys.
I like his chances.
Oh, look,
thanks.
Oh, LeBron's got his fist.
Here's Caldwell Pope. Into Drummond. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
And KCP struggling somewhat with his shot in his first season. Mostly stayed on the perimeter. He didn't get inside that often to try to get himself going. Sometimes you can get your perimeter game going by going inside. So we'll have to see how his offensive game progresses as his second season goes on.
The Pistons leading. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. And Boozer throws it down.
And that almost feels like 2 buckets coming off the steal like it did.
And especially the fact that it ties the game, Clark. The lead was about to be stretched out, and instead, we're right back to even.
Out to Smith. Fires from the wing. And that's off the glass and in. Smith's got 7 points.
And for Caldwell Pope, a volume scorer at Georgia. He's certainly shown the confidence to hit tough shots in the big moments in games. Sometimes rookies look to defer, but on a team in need of shot making, there seems a window for him to claim a larger
role. They put the lineup to start.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Kansas City. I like that song right there.
And the Pistons making a change here. Butler's checked in.
Let's go, let's go.
And then for the Lakers. Hill comes in for Sacre. And Nash is subbed in for Jeremy Lin. Nash against Jennings. Nash kicks to Johnson. Back to Nash. And stolen by Jennings. And they're pushing it up.
Oh, like that?
That
okay.
Basketball, man. Beautiful. Wow. Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark Power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Hey. Johnson's shot is off.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
Oh, and here comes Kobe all alone. And Wesley Johnson with the slam.
Great anticipation and awareness to come up with the steal and trigger the fast break.
Wow, and now it's just a one possession game thanks to that quick hit.
Hey,
fantastic basketball in the open floor. No matter who it is, that kind of defense is not going to cut it.
Here's Kobe. Makes a big high bounce and goes in.
You know, that's one way he can finish, but not the only way. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve.
Here's Jennings. And it's going to be a 3-second call.
Hour. You can't keep going up and up and up and up and up. I thought homeboy was a carpenter the way he's standing in that paint.
Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. And here's Nash outside. And another three for the Lakers.
The defenders need to talk to each other. The communication lacking there on that three-pointer. Well, a tough season for Steve Nash last year. Injuries limiting him to only a few games. And now in his 40s, it's looking like this might be his last go-around.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Well, the Lakers have been in a bit of turmoil in the last few years, and it comes back to not being able to find the right coach.
A few coaches have been given looks since the end of the Jackson era in L.A., and needless to say, it's hard to replace a guy like that.
Martin's checked in for the Pistons. Bynum comes in for Brandon Jennings. And for the Lakers, Steve, it's really hard to build something because there is a pressure to win now as well.
I would say that taking their time and not trying to rush back to winning would be the best thing that this franchise can do.
It's stolen by Johnson. Here's Kobe.
Colter.
That's good, and it's Johnson with the assist. 6 points for Kobe Bryant.
These guys got a lot of heart.
And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats
for
Los Angeles.
Got a lot of heart.
They've come out in attack mode defensively, applying pressure and stealing the ball repeatedly.
You know, another factor in their offense so far has been their ability to convert and score off turnovers.
They all got their weave.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Well, good timeout, guys, because, you know, this has been a bad run for them. He's got to get his team back on the same page and executing well together.
Sometimes just getting a stop in the action can be enough to get a team back on track.
Like he lost weight, but he's got a big head.
That little pause in the intensity of the game that lets you refocus.
I'm just saying.
So for the Pistons, Jody Meeks comes in for Mark. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Will Bynum. And then for Los Angeles, Ed Davis is checked in for Boozer. And Nick Young is subbed in for Wesley Johnson. Bryant comes with the double team. Here's Meeks. Here's Drummond. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
Now they're finally starting to shoot the ball a little bit better now.
You know, I thought this was the play, the kind of play they needed in the first quarter, but as I always like to say, it's better late than never.
major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You gotta stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it. He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Well, Kobe has always had an alpha personality, but I don't think he came into the league as a natural leader. He was more of a loner. And as his career has worn on, he's realized the need to really engage his teammates for the good of the team.
And Kobe Bryant, I think we've noticed, becoming less guarded in interviews, seems to be a little more open and forthcoming and authentic. And I think that's helped him express his personality, both with teammates and the public. And I find it to be kind of refreshing and a good thing.
The Lakers have gone 6 of 11 from the floor, over 50% shooting here in the second quarter. Fires from 14. And yes, sir, that one drops.
What, Ern?
Kobe's got 9.
Ah, the turnaround jumper. That was a thing of beauty.
And Kobe, Steve, one of the most intense competitors the league has seen. Sometimes that intensity, though, can rub teammates the wrong way.
Well, the great ones always challenge their teammates to be at their best, and sometimes, you know, it can go overboard. I think the challenge for Kobe is to figure out what makes them tick and make sure he pushes the right buttons. And their shooting really starting to pick up here in the second quarter.
Well, the lead being maintained will not be a problem if they keep shooting the way they have so far.
Good on the shot. Drummond's got his second basket.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
Yeah, and it's a strategy that has served them well in this opening half, Clark. You know, regardless of who starts the break, it seems like he's usually the one to finish it.
And that's because of how well he attacks the rim on the dead run.
Pass to Nash. Pulls it up. And another basket for the Lakers. Pistons trailed by 4. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
I'll get Nash shot down.
Here's Meeks. Good work defensively by Bryant. Los Angeles has gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. And it's Nash in the corner. Baseline try. And the Lakers tack on 2 more.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Augustine with it. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Good on the triple.
Yeah, he said it right on cue.
Here's Bryant. That misses. Would have counted had it gone in.
I wanted to call a timeout, but I can remember how to call a timeout.
Close game as we wrap up the second quarter.
Good half,
Lakers
Ern.
On top. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters.
Well, Kobe had a great quarter. He has 9 points, and he's added to his totals by picking up 3 points at the line as well.
Yeah, and that's something that's important for him and his team, getting a few extra points and knocking those free throws down and helping your team any way you can.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Inside, it's Boozer and Hill. Lynn and Kobe are your 1 and your 2. And it's Johnson in at the small forward.
Josh Smith does an awful lot of good things on the floor. As a matter of fact, he's one of the really high-quality stat sheet stuffers in the NBA. But one of the things he doesn't do quite well is shoot three-pointers. And yet he continues to insist that that be a big part of his game.
And Kobe drops them both.
Are we getting on the phone no more, Ern?
And with Josh, it started as just a way to keep teams honest with his drive. But Steve, last year he was taking threes at a record rate.
Yeah, and missing them at a career worst rate, which was the problem. I think for Smith it's important to rein in the three-point shot, to really focus on scoring inside, even the mid-range game where he's pretty good. But the three-point shot is not for everybody, that's for sure.
solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep. Yeah, you got that right, Kevin. He's such a reliable finisher.
Here's Monroe. Tries yet again. And he lays it up and in. Monroe's got his first 2 points.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
No question. Pound it into the painted area and continue to put pressure on that defense.
Kobe kicks to Hill. Stolen by Monroe. And, oh, here we go. Smith's got it. The fast break chance. Guys, we're not through three quarters of play, but six lead changes already in this one.
Yeah, it's been a really good game for sure. I mean, it looks like it's going to stay tight throughout.
Yeah, very competitive action. I agree with you, Clark. I mean, this one could come down to the last few minutes the way it looks.
And there's the defensive three-second call. The Lakers have shot 70% from the free throw line tonight, 7 for 10.
They're very average shooting team in terms of the free throw line, about 76% a year ago.
Down by one, just go ahead
and the technical free throw is good.
That's a man, you like that though. You take care of each other.
Lakers last season, and this is a remarkable factoid here, folks. That was only the sixth time in franchise history, going all the way back to the 40s. The Lakers have missed the playoffs. Obviously, Lakers fans are not.
I got a part of my wife calling me. Hold up. What's sweetheart? What's up, sweetheart? What flavor they got? Honey Smokehouse. And then if you get some of those, what was those, sweet onion rolls? Sweet onion roll buns, hamburger buns? Yeah. All right, babe. Okay, you ready?
Custom to missing the postseason.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 1-3 since starting the second half. And the Lakers with another miss. The Pistons have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. Caldwell Pope kicks to Drummond. And Carlos Boozer gets the whistle that time. Cartier Martin, he's checked in for Detroit. Randall's checked in for the Lakers. Jennings with the ball. Boozer picks him up. Now the Lakers on the break. Lynn's running.
Kobe jelly beans.
And Kobe throws it down.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor. Mm-hmm.
And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
And Johnson with the stuff.
Boy, the air floated up to the precise spot where it needed to be.
And no messing around in the finish, huh? He powers it through.
Sure didn't waste any time there.
I'll tell you what, that is going to be an alley-oop we'll see on the highlight reel the next few days.
Kobe attacking. And there's the defensive three-second call.
There, Ern. You got to come out there playing, Ern.
This will be his fifth trip to the free throw line.
Boy, he's been solid as a rock at that foul line tonight.
Well, all game he's been able to draw contact and get himself to that line.
And guys, if a game was coming down to the wire and an opponent needed to foul, I mean, he was the guy they wanted with the ball in his hands. I mean, shooting the free throws because of his proficiency there.
Yurebko's checked in for Drummond. And the Lakers also making a change. Socrates checked in for Carlos Boozer. And the call will be against Julius Randle. That's foul number two for him. Jennings kicks to Caldwell Pope. It's back to Jennings. This one for three. Oh, he misses the dunk.
Well, Greg Monroe, good size and skill at the power forward position. Loves to operate from the high post where he can make plays for others or attack off the dribble.
Here's Randle using his post move to get the 2 points. And the Lakers lead by four. Detroit's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Lynn with the steal. And then Randall slams it in.
Boy, the kind of moment you love to see. Excellent defense leading to a dunk at the other end.
Clark, you got to marvel at the transition game when they've got it clicking. It's really explosive.
High octane for sure.
Oof.
Yeah, turning defensive pressure into offensive opportunities. That's what it's all about.
Now Detroit moving it up.
Well, they won't be down for long if they can get some more early offense just like that.
Well, that's the best way to get that early offense, Clark. As soon as you come up with a steal, just sprint the other direction.
And Monroe is an elusive left-hander. He's great at driving and getting to the basket. Not really an elite athlete, but, well, I tell you, with his size and ball handling ability, he's more than capable.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. And Monroe developing his mid-range jump shot, Steve, to complete his face-up arsenal.
Well, he's made strides. I mean, it's a little concerning to see his free throw percentage falling over the last two seasons, but you know, that jump shot is key to keeping his driving lanes open.
Look here for the Pistons. Drummond's checked in for your rep. Smith comes in for Martin. Jody Meeks, he's checked in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Brandon Jennings. Nash is checked in for the Lakers. Meeks outside. And good. Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
He's got a nice touch on that shot normally, but good defense there clogging the lane.
Hold up, bro. The Pistons struggled last
night. Yeah, my wife keep calling me, but she must keep losing her call. You called me or you butt called earlier? Okay. Okay, sure. All right, ready, Arn?
Last year at home, and there were a number of factors that you could point to, but one of them was they weren't able to stretch the floor because they lacked perimeter shooting.
Offensive rebound. Here's Sacre. They shoot again. Blocked. They recover.
My guys in quick though.
And yes, sir, that one drops.
Now they got Sacre.
It seems like they're finding an open lane in the hoop every time down. It's five buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
That's good from Sacre.
Well, the former 60th pick back in 2012, Robert Sacre, is Mr. Irrelevant no longer. Get rid of that moniker. A big leap in play from his rookie season to his second campaign. And he's shown improvement across the board.
This game's going to take a big swing. Clark, if the D continues to clear out like that and give up easy dunks.
Yeah, that's the kind of defense we expect to see in a blowout, Kevin, or even an exhibition game, not a close game like this.
Look how frustrated Steve is over there.
Well, I just, you know what, Kevin? Come on, Kevin. I just like that he didn't choose to just lay it up there. I mean, he threw it down with force.
Augustine dishes to Meeks. And it's Smith penetrating.
Good job.
From outside the arc. Here's Monroe. Missed it, even after all those chances. And now here's Johnson, the fast break chance. Outside, Kobe. Out to Nash. Back to Bryant. Stolen by Monroe. Oh, and here comes Smith, all alone.
There you go, there you go.
Textbook example there of how to use defense
to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
There's Nash with the three. Nash with another miss. Kobe Bryant really making a difference here.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him, but you've got to find a way to contain him.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Okay, Earn. Don't get me wrong, Earn. Oh, you know something? I thought that was in the next quarter. I didn't realize you had a chance to make a
And
shot.
As we conclude the third quarter, what a game. Neither team giving ground. Lakers lead by two. And do not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next.
Oh, yes? Man, hold on. I hate to do, but I gotta call you back. I'm right in the middle of my book right back.
The Pistons trailing. They've got Caron Butler. Andre Drummond is out there with Jurepko. Then there's Jennings. And it's Singler and the two guard. That's the five and the four for the Pistons.
Brandon Jennings, so quick, a left-handed speed demon. You know, as quick as he is off the bounce, he's not as good of a finisher inside as you might expect. I think sometimes he makes those shots a little more difficult than they need to be.
And for Jennings, it's not just finishing at the rim. His percentages from mid-range and in between have room for growth, too. He's tried to develop a floater, but working on those one or two dribble pull-ups should also be an area of focus for him.
Pass break, Detroit. Can't get it to go.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field.
On its way from Young for two. Again, Young missing. As we're talking about Jennings finishing inside, so much of that is a mastery of angles. Steve, I know you're really mesmerized by the whole study of angles and the way players attack certain defenses. Finding that space where the shot blocker can't get to.
Yeah, geometry, Kevin, is so fascinating. And, you know, he could benefit from watching a guy like Tony Parker. He's the master at beating the big man to the backboard by putting that shot up quickly to use the rim to protect his shot.
Caldwell Pope, he's checked in for the Pistons. The Lakers also with a sub. Clarkson's checked in. Young outside. From downtown. Offensive rebound. Pistons leading by three. Caldwell Pope pass to Jennings. Takes the 12-footer and hits.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Three-pointer. And he gets it to go.
I got called timeout.
And it's an 8-point Piston lead.
Well, nothing was going down for him in the first half. But since the break, he's been on target.
Timeout called, the Lakers.
You know, it's a little strange to think of Detroit as being a team that runs, but they actually were better when they did run last year. They made good on a lot of opportunities in transition.
This is the Motor City Dancers. That's what the girls are, the Motor City Dancers.
Craig Monroe, he's checked in for Jurepko. Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Boozer, he's checked in for Davis. Johnson comes in for Ryan Kelly. Bryant is checked in for Nick Young. Nash is subbed in for Clarkson. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Byron Scott coaching his team during the break. He was not at all satisfied with their effort level, saying, "We're losing the hustle plays and all the 50-50 balls. We simply can't win that way. We've got to get after it." Let's see how they respond, Kevin.
As you said, guys, you think of basketball in the Motor City, you think of a very deliberate game and Steve Tough D.
It had been the identity of basketball in this city for a long time, Kevin. But last year, the Pistons were a top five team in fast break scoring. So, you know, when they run, they're at their best. So the city might be entering a new era in terms of the style of play.
Well, as far as the defense goes, Clark, that is not what's going to keep them in this league.
Yeah, but from the other perspective, you can see just how much that dunk pumped those players up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I agree, guys. I sense a little bit of a momentum shift here.
And there's Jennings. That's good on the assist by Butler.
10-point lead earned.
Jennings has got the lead up to 10 now for Detroit. And now we'll get a perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for the Pistons.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ball game.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast-break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
And Hill with the block. Kobe, that's for two. Again, Los Angeles.
A little lucky, frankly, but they did get it to go.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Butler. He's looking for Drummond and finds him. Let's it go from 14. And it's wide right, hits off the rim. And it's the Lakers on the break. Here's Kobe. Kobe can't get that one to fall. Detroit with the ball. They're on a 14-6 run. Fires the three. Caron Butler, and that's good.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
That ball supposed to go down.
Yeah, they're making the right play. They're working together, and they're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Jennings. Monroe with a screen on Bryant. There's Jennings with the three. Lakers trail by nine. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
And the first one drops.
I'm old, perfect half at the free throw line for him. That'll help their comeback effort for real.
I'm old.
Yeah, that's keeping them close. It's going to take a full effort here in the second half, but they've got to continue to knock down these free throws.
And the Pistons making a change here. Smith has checked in. The Lakers also with a sub. Jeremy Lin, he's checked in for Nash.
Well, you kind of expect that from him. You pretty much know what the result's going to be when he goes to the line.
The drive by Jennings. Drummond. Shot is off. Hill with some nice D. Kobe dishes to Lin. There's the three.
When I shot that,
out of bounds, Detroit
Nash
takes possession.
I said Lin. I was like, that's not how Lin shoots.
Pistons leading by seven. Outside Jennings. And that one's good. Jennings has got 24.
He has really shot the ball extremely well, as you'd expect. Like we say, he's been making sweet string music all day long.
He's trying to get this thing. He's trying to.
Boy, he wanted everybody in the building to know who threw that one down.
Hanging on the rim is, I guess, one way to do it.
It's the best way to do it, as long as you don't get teed up, I guess.
Bryant, that's for two. Rebound by the Pistons. They've led by as much as 10. And Monroe kicks to Caldwell Pope. It's stolen by Hill. In a wide open look for Lin. D Detroit with the rebound.
Safety again. Dang it.
Drummond's got 14 rebounds tonight.
That thing
going
cost me right now. I couldn't put my mind up here. Thinking that was Nash again.
Up top, Jennings. Defended by Lynn. And there's a whistle. That goes on Jeremy Lynn. That'll be his second foul of the game. On the inbound. And it's set that time on the assist by Drummond. And the Pistons lead by 9. Bryant passes to Hill. The drive by Bryant. Out left to the wing. The steal. Smith with a wide open look.
Good one, Ernest.
Drops in the tray off the fast break. And now a 12-point Detroit lead. Right side, Kobe. Outside, Lynn. And again, the Lakers no good.
I like that. Trying to respond to that last three-pointer, but he couldn't get it to go.
Outside, Jennings.
Y'all making some adjustments. I let you get the through Lynn like that. Wrong with you, Jeremy Lynn.
And so it's the Pistons taking care of business here. Not much to be critical of with this win, Clark.
Not at all. I mean, they showed up not just to play. They showed up to give great effort and to win, and they did both.
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. And now we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Brandon Jennings.
Yeah, 24. The three-point shooting was ridiculous. Smith, 2 out of 2. Meeks, 2 out of 5. Butler, 2 out of 3. I can't let you hit threes like that, Ernt. That's all right, man. I'll make sure I had a light up at this time. In there, crunch time, trying to shoot some threes.
Love muchacho, assorted flavors in these gelatos. Inspire young minds and stack my nachos with the rock determination of a vato.
Now she get no minutes. I told you. Poncho, face like because I couldn't put the, I couldn't get the lineup in there.
When the Holy Father handed my wings when I was young,
yeah.
You couldn't stand when we dream, giving me music like in the hand of. See me on the TV, the cuties. Both residential just plus and cooped it up. Got more.
Hey, did you? You need a game yet? You need a game
back
yet?
In time, you be Judge Ito. I know you think it neato. It repeats the minute. Something
that's
like a Tito, but it's 300,000 more with no remote. Jacob and Lorraine, I used to deal with Tito, but he clowned me and told me that my money's Fritos. Now the Enzo doors go up like a D-Lo. Rion, same song sung on my man Nego. SLR, when the doors go up, it's like a fresh hell jar. We boss, he shall not get hot, he too frost. Yes, sir. Close your eyes, just picture yourself just holding pies. Implement a plan and you surely rise. That's promised by the man that controlled the skies.
He ain't gave me the morning, mom.
So ill, better yet, doggy, just tell me how you feel.
I give her no time to
how you feel, though? We just picture, thinking, dreaming, scheming.
Oh, no, she ain't mad because I told her this morning. Shaking, boiling, lacing, baking, shaping. I tell her a long time.
Gotta get this cake right as I serve it. You just burn it, breathe it, learn it. Now, watch you take flight.
They give me a break, but like, it shows we want to watch, you know what I'm saying? Yes, I didn't mean to be on there this long.
You don't know me, I'm Paul Howard, you Paul, Paul Holy. First trick on the ramp is the rock and rolly. Keep one on my stack with a new pro.
You got to get all three, man, you got to get all three. Don't watch it,
but a fourth beat to chuckle at what critics have written. He dresses insane, but his music admire.
Oh, you did see, okay, I didn't know you did, okay.
Vanity Fair, you like Kennedy, yeah, but you should guess who's in the insanity chair.
You like it?
Now it ain't about what I want, still thumbing through my life like... It's one thing to say that you did it. It's one
I know
thing
she
to lie about
she playing that character.
It's one thing to say that you live it. It's another to admit it.
But I admit I got all this paper plus the prettiest faces that's offered by nature.
Hold on,
want to meet him in my house. I got space like NASA.
Kazula ain't seen it yet.
It's a simple clue between us and imposters. We hop in the air and don't care what it cost us. Now I'm with nerd with a pit full of marshes. I guess you could say that we fly like saucers. Zapping that
class and that vigor.
The cash and crash with us.
You got me feeling against a whole NBA over here. First game I played against my team. Next game,
just picture yourself, implement a plan and you surely rise. That's promised by the man that controlled the skies.
I'll just tell you this, sir. This time, better yet, doggy, just tell me how you feel. I'll make sure I be able to put my line up in. That's wrong with you, dog.
We just picture thinking, dreaming, scheming. Reading all in the late night, shaking, boiling, lacing, baking, shaping, shaving. Gotta get this cake right as I serve it. You just burn it, breathe it, learn it. Now watch you take flight.
I only call the street.
How does it feel?
Don't believe it or lie to you.
Yes, sir. You don't know me.
Clarkson. Kelly. I ain't get a chance to do none of this right here. I ain't tell them who to play through. This is important, Ernst. You know what I'm saying, man? That's what you beat me, though. You hit too many threes, Ernst. I can't let you hit the threes, man. But the key was the lineup, the starting lineup was all jacked up.
Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live in Los Angeles at the Staples Center. Glad to have you with us for more NBA action.
Yeah,
I'm Kevin Harlan introducing the rest of the 2K broadcast team, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and sideline reporter Doris Burke. And now the opening lineup for Detroit. Monroe and Drummond there inside. On the wings, Case.
Oh! Look out!
Watch out below. Wow!
Now that was pretty. That was just a nice-looking reverse jam right there.
Use the rim, Clark, to protect the ball, I think, too, a little bit.
Yeah, did a nice job with it.
Yeah, no question, Kevin. Great awareness and terrific finish.
Stolen by Boozer. And now here's Johnson, the fast-break chance. Outside for Kobe. It's taken away by Smith. Caldwell Pope dishes to Jennings. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. And Wesley Johnson.
You know that's
the
four. You know that's a four. You always
have
a four.
That's the easiest opportunity an offense can get off a steal.
Exactly. No defense for that.
Caldwell Pope passes to Monroe. That's good. We play just over a minute here in the first. Jennings against Nash. Pulls from the top of the key.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
Smith kicks to Monroe. And taken away by Johnson. And here they go.
Way to go, guy. Everybody's
team coming off an assist from Bryant.
Touch pass.
And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
They've come out in attack mode defensively, applying pressure and stealing the ball repeatedly.
They also came out of the locker room with their running shoes on. I mean, their transition game has been full throttle.
Now that is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
Well, with only one attempt so far falling, this is not looking good. 1 for 4 so far.
Oh, Cole.
Can't get it to go.
That would have been a nice alley-oop there.
Well, you got to love the effort, though. Almost showtime.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
I got to find something. You're right.
They've had a cold start so far. Just 1 of 5 from the floor here early.
And now the Pistons, fast break. Smith with the ball. They grab their own miss. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points.
Boy, what a great job making good on the second opportunity. He stayed with that play from start to finish.
On the wing, Johnson. Back to Nash. Shot clock at 5. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. Detroit with the rebound.
Well, the Lakers have been in a bit of turmoil in the last few years. And it comes back to not being able to find the right coach.
Back up, jump, step back, jump.
Plenty of space.
I like that right there. Step up, jumper.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Jennings drives in. And Detroit again with the bucket.
Looked like he was trying to go for a degree of difficulty points on that shot.
And Nash gets double teamed. Pass to Johnson. Left side, Boozer. The dish out to Nash. Nails the 16-footer. Nash has got his second basket of the game.
I know you like to play off fast.
You know, he was smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Agreed. As long as he picks his spots, his outside shot will be hard to block, no matter who's on it.
Jennings can't get it to go.
That's a shot he's got.
I hate when
hit.
They do that
you
right
don't
there.
Get too many better looks from that range.
Well, big group substitution here for the Lakers.
I'll be doing on a button that
Randall's
wrong.
Checked in I for Hill. Davis comes in for Boozer. Young's checked in for Kobe. And it's Clarkson in for Steve Nash. And a different look here for the Pistons. Yurebko's checked in for Drummond. Butler comes in for Smith. Jody Meeks, he's checked in for Caldwell Pope. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Brandon Jennings. Augustine, Pope loose. And it's DJ Augustine with the foul. That's his first foul. Xavier Henry, he's checked in for the Lakers. Clarkson passes to Henry. And that one good for Clarkson. Clarkson's got his first points in this one.
Drafted, second round.
Nice pass. That one was right on target.
We bought it.
Monroe sets a screen for Augustine. Shoots off the screen.
We didn't have a second
and
round
it comes off the front of the rim. Somebody.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick. Just couldn't get the shot to go.
Boy, you love to see that as a basketball purist. Guy setting a good screen and then getting the shot opportunity.
Here's Young. Rebound, Detroit. Monroe's got 3 rebounds now in this one.
You know, there's always a lot of nicknames in the NBA. I loved what became of Nick Young last year at L.A. All of a sudden, he dubbed himself Swaggy P, and it caught on. Kind of loved watching him play and referring to him by that nickname. One step ahead of the defense when he fired that pass for the assist.
Thank and the girl. Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here.
Right.
And Nick Swaggy Young, they call him Swaggy P.
Swaggy
never
Young, Swaggy
swaggier.
P. He's in the game
last
now.
Season, the top scoring rate of his career and some of the best efficiency as well. He has some huge nights.
Your coach still got the mumps. Why did this coach go ahead and coach again? Everybody's sick.
Pistons trailed by 6. And Young, a good ball handler. He can get his shot whenever he wants.
And that's often, Kevin. Don't expect a lot of assists from him. This is a guy who, when he touches the ball, it's going up.
Up and in on the layup.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle much more effectively.
Yeah, and until they do, the problems inside are only going to get worse.
Now the Lakers on the break. Cashes in for a double-digit lead.
I love the aggressiveness with their approach, pounding the ball inside, and it's working.
They are owning this game early. They are constantly finding lanes to the basket.
Meeks can't hit.
tell you what, if their success on the boards in this first quarter is any indication, it's going to be a good day.
And rebounds usually are a good indicator.
What a start they've gotten off to. A big lead for them, and we're not even out of the first quarter yet.
And it's not just their hot offense here. I mean, they're playing very strong defense, too, guys.
Well, their plan of attack has been pretty clear to see. Get the ball inside and just take it strong to the hoop. Be dominant in the lane.
Well, the defense has been very slow to adjust. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Shot to stop the run. And it's laid in by Monroe. Monroe's got six.
Well, he's been working hard to get good looks, and it's paying off for him early.
Randall. Here's Clarkson.
Oh.
The first quarter concludes in a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. Lakers ahead, up by 12. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And Stephen Clark, Lakers are pretty much in control here.
Yeah, everything's gone right for this club offensively. They are really putting it together.
Not too many speed bumps in the road as they built this lead.
Here are the five. Detroit has to start the second quarter. On the wings, KCP and Josh Smith. Monroe and Drummond, they're inside. And it's Jennings in at the one spot. Kobe attacking. Down low. Lynn. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play. Wesley Johnson's checked in for Young. Lakers shooting their first foul shot of the game.
Yeah, very average shooting team in terms of the free throw line. About 76% a year ago.
Jennings dishes to Smith. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Wesley Johnson picks one up.
Josh Smith, signed by the Pistons last year to that big four-year, $54 million contract. You know, the fit was problematic, particularly on the front line trying to play next to Andre Drummond and Greg Monroe. I think it's important for Smith to have shooting around him. Otherwise, teams just sag off and they take away his driving lanes.
Pistons trailed by 16. It's deflected. Drummond with it. He's picked up by Hill. That shot by Caldwell Pope, no good.
Such a solid performance for them inside. Their rebounding has been terrific.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that rack.
You know, the guys on the bench are going crazy right now at the sight of that jam. That's foul number two on him. It might not warrant sitting him entirely, but another one before halftime, they could be in some trouble. Brandon Jennings, so quick, a left-handed speed demon. You know, as quick as he is off the bounce, he's not as good of a finisher inside as you might expect. I think sometimes he makes those shots a little more difficult than they need to be.
Lynn kicks to Bryant. Yes! And a nice assist from Lynn.
Running up Princeton now, man.
For Kobe Bryant.
Everybody in the right spot now, Aaron.
Broke out the finger roll, guys. That was kind of a stylish finish.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
I see your players look at the Lakers.
And for Jennings, it's not just finishing at the rim. His percentages from mid-range and in between have room for growth, too. He's tried to develop a floater, but working on those one or two dribble pull-ups should also be an area of focus for him.
I like this routine they're doing right now. I like that one. Yeah.
Pistons trailed by 18. As we're talking about Jennings finishing inside, so much of that is a mastery of angles. Steve, I know you're really mesmerized by the whole study of angles and the way players attack certain defenses, finding that space where the shot blocker can't get to it.
Yeah, geometry, Kevin, is fascinating. And, you know, he could benefit from watching a guy like Tony Parker. He's the master at beating the big man to the backboard by putting that shot up quickly to use the rim to protect his shot.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Well, thank you, Kevin. Julius Randle, the fresh-faced rookie for the Lakers, wore number 30 in college at Kentucky and wears it now. As a kid, he asked his mother if it was okay if he wore the same number that she used to wear. She said if he wore it, he had to do something with it. Big shoes to fill, but he's up to the task, guys.
I like his chances. Thanks.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Deflects the pass. It's stolen by Smith. And he lobs it up toward the rim. And it's Monroe finishing it off.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
This crowd just stunned at the sight of that one.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. And the Lakers making a change here. Nash has checked in. Detroit also making some changes. Martin comes in for Greg Monroe. And it's Bynum in for Brandon Jennings. Lakers leading by 18.
One of the problems for the Pistons last year was they seemed to collapse late in game. Found a lot of opportunities that went awry in due to poor performances in the fourth quarter.
No one near Smith as he lets it go. Nailed from three-point land.
And he's shaken off a poor first quarter shooting effort. He's really starting to turn it on now, guys.
Here's Hill. The kick out to Bryant. It's back to Hill. That's in, coming off an assist from Bryant. Kobe's got his fifth assist in this one.
Talk about the Pistons letting games go late. They were one of the worst teams in the fourth quarter in both defense and scoring.
Thinking again about Detroit Clark, it would have been fatigue or just careless basketball that did him in late, but they really did just run out of steam, it seemed like, every game.
Well, it shows that you can play well for three quarters, even great at times for three quarters, 36, 38, 40 minutes, but you and I always talk about it's a 48-minute game, and you've got to run through the finish line, not to it.
Kyle Singler's checked in for Detroit. And the shot is good. 9 points for Johnson.
That's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
Smith the pass to Drummond. Stolen by Boozer. Near the three-point line, it's Nash. And that's a foul called on Kyle Singler. That is his first foul of the game.
Obviously, he's not afraid of physical play, but he still needs to play in control.
And he definitely wasn't in control that time. Everybody in the building knew it was an over-the-back call.
Here's what Detroit's going with right now. Yurebko's checked in for Andre Drummond, and Caron Butler is subbed in for Smith. Los Angeles shooting their second and third free throws tonight. The first one falls.
Wes Johnson, the former number four pick back in 2010. He was a bust in Minnesota, but he shot better in his fourth season. And once he was moved to kind of a small four, like the shooting power forward spot, he really found a niche for himself.
Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for Detroit. Jennings comes in for Will Bynum. It's back to Jennings. For the three, that's good. Jennings has got 5 points now in the quarter.
He can be a forgotten man in their offense sometimes, but, you know, the defense still needs to keep an eye on him.
Near the three-point line, it's Nash. Can't nail the jumper.
Nash, I'll need you to pay yourself.
And he continues to search for his rhythm. It's eluded him to this point.
Butler on the way. And taken away by Johnson. The finish.
Watch out! Oh, what a throwdown there. Man!
And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen throughout. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively turning into quick points.
And that's not going to be able to continue if they hope to get back into this game, Clark. It's a deflating play for your morale.
Los Angeles leading by 19. Nash with it. And Jennings picks him up defensively. Shot is blocked.
And it seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
Here's Singler. Boozer with the defensive effort.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Here's Kobe. Takes a big high bounce and goes in. Bryant's got 14.
You got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
Here's Singler. No good on the triple. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter. So shot's good by Kobe.
And assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Really an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Jennings dishes to Jurepko. And it is flushed down with a nice jam. A free run to the hoop and some thunder on the finish.
Not exactly the way the D would have drawn that one up.
And when you got the space, you might as well throw it down. That's what I always used to do.
Dan Davis wide open. He shoots. I'm no good trying to beat them. So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. Lakers lead by 21. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime.
You heard my team feeling, right?
Now it's been a one-sided affair so far through the first two quarters, but there's plenty of time to mount a comeback. You look at Kobe Bryant in this game, I mean, he has been everywhere.
He's seen the court so well tonight. He's made some phenomenal passes here in the game so far in that first half.
You know, some folks say he's not a playmaker, but he's dispelling all of that nonsense.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters.
Kobe having just a fantastic game. He's got 16 points and 5 assists. He's a one-man wrecking crew out there.
No, they have no answer for him at this point.
Nash and Bryant in the backcourt. Inside, it's Boozer and Hill. And it's Johnson in at the three spot. That's the Laker five. There's Jennings with the three. Jennings can't get that one to fall.
And in the paint, they have really shown some strength. Their work on the boards has been phenomenal.
Yeah, I'd certainly call it a mismatch, Steve, at least for today.
Well, you know, for the last couple of seasons, we've seen the Lakers really struggle with injuries to their star players, and it's shed a less than flattering light on the team's bench depth. It's forced guys to step into roles that perhaps they aren't quite ready to handle.
The drive by Bryant. Here's Hill. That's in, coming off an assist by Kobe.
And he just used his height that time down low. That's going to be pretty hard to defend against.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. And some feel the Lakers, Steve, failed to really address their bench depth, whether in the draft or free agents.
Well, you know, generally they've had success with broad strokes. I mean, acquiring star players over the years. But with the new salary restrictions, it takes away a lot of the advantage that the Lakers have had over the years. So this may be a new era for this franchise in terms of team building.
That wasn't the game. That's me taking care of some stuff over here, man.
Robert Sacre, he's checked in for the Lakers.
Now you turn into a button pusher. Don't start being a button pusher, all right?
Pistons have gotten just one of their first four shots to fall since coming out of the locker room at the break. Deep
good
two
D,
from Jennings. They get the rebound. For three, Smith. And that one's good. Smith's got nine. Lakers leading by 22. And Kobe throws it down.
Fantastic dunk, and he decided to hang around up there for a while, Kevin.
Well, maybe, you know, he didn't want to land awkwardly. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe it was a safety move.
Or maybe he just wanted to give the photographers a better angle for the shot.
18 feet out. Kicks it out to Johnson. And Nash, here we go. Drains the 19-footer. He's got six.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
It's tipped. Stolen by Boozer. He lobs up the alley-oop pass.
Good pass from there.
Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
A different look here for Detroit. Jody Meeks comes in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Brandon Jennings.
And that's one of his strengths, knocking down those long-range jumpers. DJ Augustine playing big minutes for the Bulls last season with Derrick Rose hurt. And I'll tell you what, he put up some big numbers at times. 27 points in back-to-back
comeback,
games.
Huh?
Well, he's been a real positive factor for them today, although, you know, as a team, they've had a lot of negatives mixed in there as well.
Timeout called the Lakers. Well, you knew that Andre Drummond was oozing with potential, but that P word, potential, you know, can quite often be as much of a curse, Clark, as it is a boon. But he just blossomed last year.
Yeah, he really did. I mean, with the way he moves around the floor at his size, you had to know that if he started to put it all together, he would be a game-changing talent, and he showed flashes of that and made a big leap last season.
Yurebko's checked in from Monroe.
There you go.
And the defense paying instant dividends. Fast break basket.
Yeah, that transition was immediate. Didn't waste a second getting out on the break.
Bryant gets a wide open look. And the Lakers with another miss.
And you said with Drummond, you know, the movement and fluidity of him, he makes the extraordinary seem so easy at times. Very much a highlight reel machine at such a young age.
Meeks outside. The rebound by Sacre.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. That plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Yeah, not to mention what it says on the scoreboard. I mean, they're really pushing them around physically at this point.
You know, the highlight plays will always be there for a guy like Drummond. Size, speed, athleticism. But, you know, he was able to take on a lot more minutes last year and did not see an incredible efficiency drop off, which is impressive. I think that could be just a sign of things to come for this young man.
That's what you do. That's how you do it.
And Carlos Boozer gets the whistle that time. A platoon swap here for the Lakers. And the Pistons making a change here as well. Martin's checked in. And it's Smith penetrating. And Meeks kicks to Smith. Off his leg. And the ref's whistling a kick ball. Here's Augustine. Smith with a screen on Lynn. Here's Drummond. And good. Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
Well, it wasn't a textbook pick, but he still managed to score. Good concentration on the finish.
Meeks outside. Good. Meeks got 5 points now in the quarter.
And another three-pointer to their second half total.
Yeah, they caught that long-range bug at halftime, and it's been bombs away ever since.
Young from outside. It's Drummond with the rebound. Drummond's got 7 rebounds in the game. Got a piece of it. And Young comes over to help. Smith kicks to Drummond. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
How about that? Snuck in off the baseline and then the sensational reverse jam.
How pretty was that? You're right. Athletic basketball. Clark with a little bit of flair mixed in.
I like that flavor.
Flavor.
Me too.
Flavor and flair. I like that.
And there's a whistle that goes on Jeremy Lin. That's his first foul. Butler, he's checked in for Jody Meeks. That's a 2 from Martin. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
You've got to give them a lot of credit for the job they've done on the backcourt.
Well, they've done a lot of things right, but I agree with you, Clark. Their rebounding is right there at the top of the list.
Davis kicks to Young. Lock at 6. Tries from 16. And he hits the jump shot.
He said he's going to do something, then did it.
Had so much space there, and the defense really not showing him the respect. You can see his eyes get wide.
Dang.
And it's good.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Shoots the 3. Count that one. Young's got 5 points now this quarter.
A wide open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
Augustine passes to Drummond. And off the front iron, and in it goes. Drummond's got 10 points in the game.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, 4 of their last 5 baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
To the paint. Here's Butler. Can't hit from in close. Well, through 3 quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome.
Nice comeback, though, huh?
Los Angeles on top, leading by 17. And we're just moments. Pistons trailed by 17. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. On the floor for Detroit, Josh Smith and Greg Monroe at the 3 and 4. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope is out there with Jennings. And it's Drummond in the 5 spot.
Really,
and plenty
ankle
of contact on the shot, so 2 free throws coming up.
Kobe Bryant in his 19th season in the league, but remember, he's played in 220 career playoff games. That's almost 3 additional seasons worth of games. Then you factor in his play with Team USA. I tell you, he's got a lot of mileage on those legs.
So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe. And Kobe Bryant, top 5 in all-time minutes played.
And, Kevin, you know those minutes add up, but he's found ways to overcome the wear and tear and still remain effective. His great skill level and ability to make tough, contested shots remains valuable.
Pistons trailed by 16.
Oh, like that. No.
And Craig Monroe with the slam.
Boy, he is a strong finisher on the fast break.
Yeah, he sure is. He remains in total control, even at full speed. I love that about him.
Another shot. Johnson, a wide open look. From outside, off the mark. The Pistons have gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. And it's slammed in by Smith.
Maybe that'll ignite him. I mean, impossible not to get pumped up after that. At least I think that would be the case.
Well, you could see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are. Look at them. They are pumped up.
Yeah, they're geeked.
That's what those alley-oops do, though.
Smith with the block. And it's out of bounds. The Lakers able to take possession here. Los Angeles calls timeout.
Are you playing like you're trying to come back, dude?
Josh Smith does an awful lot of good things on the floor. As a matter of fact, he's one of the really
high-quality stat sheet stuffers in the NBA. But one of the things he doesn't do quite well is shoot three-pointers. And yet he continues to insist that that be a big part of his game.
First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. Johnson, a wide open look. Drains it from beyond the arc. Johnson's got 20 points.
Another good look there, and that's his second three-pointer of the game.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
You know, all coaches hate defensively when you give up easy points in the paint. That's inexcusable. So that's the reason for this timeout here.
I think it came down to the fact they were getting beat inside, and that's why the coach called timeout. They were not winning the battle inside.
Beautiful.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Over that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what Stan Van Gundy said to the team. He got after them and told them to turn up the intensity, saying, "We put ourselves in a corner, and now we've got to fight our way out. Show me what you have. Let's see if we've got what it takes, guys."
The tries. That's good.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
Near the three-point line, it's Nash. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark.
He has yet to get into the flow of this game. His teammates have done their part, but they need him to pick his game up.
And they'll keep possession. They double him with Drummond. Johnson, wide open, he fires. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got three assists in the game. Feeds it to Smith. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. So Smith will go to the line. Wesley Johnson picks one up. All right, we'll take a look now at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
That was good up, man.
And their mid-range shooting continues to be accurate.
Well, you've also got to love how aggressively they've taken that ball to the basket and scored off dribble penetration.
Smith wide open. He fires. Drains the three-pointer. Smith's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Getting the feel out there from long range, guys. That's
nice.
His second three of the half.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
There's Jennings with the three. Pistons keep it alive.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game, and even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
Johnson, a wide open look. His three-pointer is off the mark. Pistons trailed by 16. Jennings with the ball. Guarded now by Nash.
I wonder if switching baskets really threw him off. Because he can't get anything to fall this half.
Los Angeles has gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Bryant can't get it to go.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there. That's the epitome of teamwork right there, Kevin, on the alley-oop.
Clark, what about the finish bringing it down with some thunder?
Yeah, lightning too.
But I'll tell you, the pass was even better. He put it on an absolute platter for him.
Johnson gets the bucket.
See Jackson trapping his hand.
Showing some kind of killer instinct.
Right here.
Trying to stretch this lead out.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over.
Well, a tough season for Steve Nash last year. Injuries limiting him to only a few games. And now in his 40s, it's looking like this might be his last go-round.
Because I'm looking at the Lakers girls, I ain't paying attention.
Caron Butler's checked in for Detroit. Jody Meeks comes in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Pistons trailed by 16. And for Steve Nash, the last couple seasons, issues with his hip, hamstring, fractured leg, and then nerve damage. It's been tough sledding.
Yeah, it really has been, and it's a product of a long Hall of Fame career, and the body inevitably starts to wear down. I mean, it's tough, but I understand his motivation to finish his career on his terms, especially after all the work he's put in to get him back on the court. But sometimes the storybook ending you desire just doesn't come to be.
Brandon Jennings acquired in a sign and trade by the Pistons last season on a 3-year, $24 million contract.
Jennings probably expecting more in terms of the deal. Maybe it was a wake-up call for him. You know, he has not been part of a winning team yet. And generally speaking, you know, stats alone don't get you max contracts. Stats and wins are what do that, and that's what's next for Jennings.
Ball's knocked loose. The drive by Bryant. Good!
Okay, knocked it to the
Kobe's
damn turnbuckle.
Got 23.
Time to turn out the lights on this game.
I think they deserve a ton of credit for the way they played here today. Truly a professional display.
And that one's good.
And for Jennings, a quick, explosive athlete at the point. But you talk about how can he improve. He has the physical attributes to become a lockdown defender. But his focus at that end comes and goes. He's got to be more consistent in his focus at that end.
Here is Bryant.
And this is what they wanted, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. And I think it can be considered a statement win for Los Angeles.
Not only did they shoot the ball better, but they had more assists.
Well, the ball movement was good. The player movement was excellent. And you only get assists when guys make shots.
Beyond the actual result of this game, I think fans are going to look back and see this was just a monstrous performance for Wesley Johnson. It was the kind of game for him that all scorers dream of, where the basket just seems to be incredibly wide.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. Here's Henry. And it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the bucket.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
And the other aspect for Jennings, a streaky score to this point in his career. A little loose with his mechanics and shot selection, I think, a part of it. I think improving his shooting percentages is an area where he needs to get better.
And they will call over the back on the play.
On the back of his neck.
That was kind of clumsy looking. He was not going to get away with that.
He climbed all over him like he was on the ladder. I mean, that's an easy over-the-back call there.
And a different look here for the Pistons. Your Rebco's checked in for Andre Drummond. Singler comes in for Josh Smith. Cartier Martin, he's checked in for Butler. And it's Bynum in for Brandon Jennings. Clarkson.
I like the way the rookie plays.
And that's going to be too many steps. Gets the whistle on the travel.
And I think this is going to be too much to overcome, Clark. What do you think?
All the sand in the hourglass is gone, and I agree with you.
We've got 13 seconds left in the game.
Kick it out, kick it out.
Now Lynn.
One.
And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation
of
the NBA on 2K Sports. And now we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Wesley Johnson.
What happened is they felt like... Well, yeah, man, remember we played on Superstar. Let's see what happens when we go to Hall of Fame. 1, 2, 3. Dropping 10, 11 rebounds. If we're wrong, 14 and 8. The boys are monsters.
It ain't right what them boys be doing on the boards. All right. Yeah, a lot of boards. It ain't right neither. Hill had 12. Hill had 12. Booze had 11 rebounds. It is way at the bottom. See, I got to incorporate my Boozer into the game. I don't shoot with him yet, but we'll get there, Ernst. We all will get there. Let's see what you shot. 44% I shot. 53%. Free throws, we both shot. Well, I made 4 out of 5, made 6 out of 9. Fast break points, 28 to 17.